This is Martin Fackler for the New York Times. Japan's very well prepared for things like earthquakes and tsunamis. It's a country where these sorts of seismic events are common. The refugee centers were designated by city governments and local governments before the waves came. One of the remarkable things is how the communities in Japan have really banded together to take care of themselves. They've become more and more dependent on the government over time because they need the government's resources. But in the early days, they were almost all volunteer run. The problem has been, though, that the refugee centers that I visited still lacked electricity. They lacked running water. People had a minimum amount of food per day. They did have some space heaters, so they were having at least some relief from the cold. And by the way, it's very cold here. It was snowing today in the area that I visited, and temperatures were in the high 20s Fahrenheit. The big question was whether or not they would return to their town. And so they were talking about the possibility that entire neighborhoods would not rebuild. Adding to this is the fact that, like many parts of rural Japan, the population of Ofunato was made up of a lot of elderly residents. These folks told me that they quite simply didn't have the energy or the financial wherewithal to rebuild the towns. And so there's the possibility that these communities will hollow out or perhaps even vanish altogether.